Welcome to sold-out B&D Spring Stadium in Brawltimore, Scaryland. You folks watching from home are in for a real treat today, as these teams will look to do the impossible, the unthinkable, and the absolutely unimaginable.
What's that, Ren?
Raise Brawltimore's already sky-high homicide rate. The teams are juiced up and ready for blood as they take the field for MFL action. The Leaveland Burns take on the Brawltimore Razors. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Yo, man, nobody can touch what I call. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
It's time to turn on, tune in, and get your mutant buzz on. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow here. It's MFL game day, and you know what that means.
Yeah, the town will be in flames tonight, and half the city's population will be sliding down green street poles and eating all-you-can-eat horseshit buffets from the curb.
Yes, victory can be bittersweet sometimes, Bricks. Let's see if the home team can light up this town like a Roman candle. And it's first and ten. Up 2 yards on the pass.
Then this guy's 6 feet tall. He could just have fallen over and gotten 2 yards.
And that'll be second and eight to go. Man, this guy just exploded into flames. Now the defense has to try to tackle a running bomb. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. Open space is running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. You have got to be kidding me. My sister could have made that kick. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. And the kicker just bit the dust on that play. Someone will have to come off the bench to replace him. And it's first and ten.
Not one.
Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. Second down and nine.
Not one, not two, not.
He's got his beast boost working. The player just transformed into a violent form of pure badass. Bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
Oh, no, that was totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. Yeah. I hope they have raincoats in the front row, because that was splattering everywhere.
First and ten.
Not one, not two, not three.
He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage.
So was that cheerleader.
A man from prison just came out of the field.
It's the ref, idiot.
Oh.
Let's see what the penalty is. first down and one. And he runs it in for the touchdown. The extra point attempt. And this guy couldn't hit the side of a fallout shelter. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
First and ten.
It looks like the defense handed out shrinking pills.
That's a ginormous dirty trick there, Bricks. And he held on to that one for a first down. And it's first and ten.
This is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
And it's first and ten. And they call a ginormous dirty trick.
It's so big at the last.
Oh, and he fumbles the ball on that hit. When you hurdle and get hit, chances for a fumble increase. Force meets the explodable object. Boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
He was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
And it's first and ten. It's first and ten. Boom to the moon! Another loser bites the dust. In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
It's first and ten.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Second down in a very lot. That's about a 3-yard pickup. Third down and 10. First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take. Well, that's a strange penalty called right there.
I'm starting to notice that this ref likes talking, and it don't make much sense.
No, but he's making a lot of dollars.
Third down and the offense jumps on sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not gonna take it anymore. Third down and the offense needs a miracle. Thank you. Bricks. You can't lose your head in the heat of battle like he did. Just slows the game down. The offense lost another running back and only two remain on their roster. When a team loses all their running backs, they lose their ability to run the ball.
Yeah, like if I rip out your tongue, you won't be able to speak. Tell us something we don't know, genius.
Oh boy, they're going for it. This could get uglier than the baby resulting from an orcish family reunion.
Wow, the quarterback just, that was a good throw. And assuming he was aiming for the ground, the ref calls a penalty. You know, the MFL has eliminated almost every penalty in the rule book, and yet it still feels like there's way too many penalties.
Stupid jerks, you guys suck.
And it's first and 10. Defense had enough with this ref and jumps off sides to kill him. And it's first and 10.
First down! I see this guy drop a lot of...
Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the MFL. And it's first and 10. He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? The offense has no running backs left, so this becomes a passing-only offense.
They can still run it with their QB, right, Finn?
Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron.
Hey, watch it!
And that'll be second and 8 to go. And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. First down and 5. That pass play was good for 3 yards. And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. It's a glitterception!
What's that, Grim?
A fabulous interception! And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point!
And a well-placed cleat!
First and 10.
Hot one.
He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage. Second down and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
And that's a sack.
Speaking of sacks, has anybody seen my powder? I'll get you my crazy over here.
I thought the only tie we'd see would be a noose. Instead, they're in a dead heat. Tie game at the end of 1. Third down and, well, good luck.
Hot one, hot two, hot eight.
And he picks up about 6 on the play. Sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. And he put all of his foot in. Ouch! Anyone in the mood for a steak tartare? Pow! With the brain scrambler! It's first and 10. He broke free and has open field in front of him. And he's able to grab that one somehow. Oh, holy smokes. He just killed that player with a cheap shot. That's why we love the MFL.
I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you.
First and 10. And the quarterback throws another pick.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard.
Oh, man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. First and 10.
One.
Pickup of about 3 on that play. And that's a hell of a cheap shot. Gotta love it. Second down and 7. A nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. Third down and a pussy hair. I don't know whose eyes the QB. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my off season.
First and 10.
Hey, man, you see that? That's right. You can't handle this. You can't handle what I got. Yeah, get the hell out of here, man.
Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. And he was stuck to him like glue. Third down, and the QB is saying his prayers. And the defense gets another pick. Man, he just slipped away like a greased pig. Oh, what the... Oh, man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
And it's first and 10. They could not connect on that play. Second down and 10. First and 10. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that. And the Brawltimore Razors not only lose at home, they lose by forfeit. Man, that's double the humiliation. Like being rejected by a woman who's also, well, fat. It's probably a good thing the game ended up in forfeit. They weren't gonna make it out of the stadium alive with this performance anyway. The fans were gonna kill them if the opposition didn't.
Gotta love that fan passion.
Let's hear what the game's MVP has to say about this carnage.
I'd rather listen to Sarah Palin read the entire works of Shakespeare while tripping my brains out.
Actually, that sounds kind of fun.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it, so you...